Liberty Nation, truth is making a comeback.
Gentlewoman from New York, Ms. Ocasio-Cortez, is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Mr. Sloan, earlier today you said that Wells Fargo does not put profits over people, correct?
That's correct.
I'm interested in the human rights abuses and environmental disasters that some say are financed by your bank, Wells Fargo. In a recent Guardian article by Crystal Tubles and Matt Remley, they stated, Wells Fargo has pursued profits without principles by investing in private prisons, for-profit immigration detention centers, loan shark-like payday lending, and holding much of the bond debt, strangling Puerto Rico's efforts to lift itself out of its financial crisis. Is it true that Wells Fargo has invested or financed in some of these industries?
We made a decision 2 years ago to exit the two relationships that we had with two private prisons firms. One has been exited, and then when the credit agreement with the other one amortizes and matures, mm-hmm. we will no longer have that relationship.
Are those two companies Geo Group and CoreCivic?
Correct.
And which one has been exited, Geo Group or CoreCivic?
I can't recall exactly which one. But,
okay. Yep. Madam Chair, I'd like to seek unanimous consent to submit 3 reports highlighting the bank's role in debt financing these groups, the for-profit prison companies running ICE detention facilities.
Without objection, such is the order.
Mr. Sloan, why was the bank involved in the caging of children and financing the caging of children to begin with?
I don't know how to answer that question because we weren't.
You were financing and involved in debt financing of CoreCivic and Geo Group, correct?
For a period of time, we were involved in financing one of the firms, we're not anymore, and the other. I'm not familiar with the specific assertion that you're making, but we weren't directly involved in that.
Okay, so these companies run private detention facilities run by ICE, which is involved in caging children, but I'll move on. Mr. Sloan, Wells Fargo was also an investor and a major investor in the Dakota Access Pipeline and the Keystone XL pipelines. They were prime investors and lenders to companies building these pipelines in defiance of Standing Rock Sioux's treaty rights to protect its water and sacred lands. They warned early on, the Lakota Sioux warned early on that the pipeline was unstable and bound to leak. Despite that, it was built anyway, and it has leaked at least 5 times. And the Keystone XL in particular had one leak that leaked 210,000 gallons across South Dakota. Since Wells Fargo financed the building of this pipeline in an environmentally unstable way, why shouldn't the bank be held responsible for financing the cleanup of the disasters from these projects?
Which pipeline are you referring to?
Either. You know,
so we were not involved in the financing of the XL pipeline. We were one of the 17 or 19 banks that was involved in the financing of the Dakota Access Pipeline.
Okay, so Wells Fargo hasn't financed any company associated with the Keystone XL pipeline?
No, I didn't say that. I said we're not involved in financing that pipeline specifically.
Okay, so let's focus on the Dakota Access Pipeline. Should Wells Fargo be held responsible for the damages incurred by climate change due to the financing of fossil fuels and these projects?
I don't know how you'd calculate that, Congresswoman.
Say from spills or when we have to reinvest in infrastructure building seawalls from the erosion of infrastructure or cleanups, wildfires, et cetera?
Related to that pipeline? I'm not aware that there's been any of what you described that's mm-hmm. occurred related
to that.
How about
the cleanups from the leaks of the Dakota Access Pipeline?
I'm not aware of the leaks associated with the Dakota Access Pipeline that you're describing.
So hypothetically, if there was a leak from mm-hmm. the Dakota Access Pipeline, mm-hmm. Why shouldn't Wells Fargo pay for the cleanup of it since it paid for the construction of the pipeline itself?
Because we don't operate the pipeline. We provide financing to the company that's operating the pipeline. Our responsibility is to ensure that at the time that we make that loan, that that customer, and we have a group of people in Wells Fargo, including an environmental oversight group, headed by one of my colleagues who used to be at the EPA.
Why did Wells Fargo finance this pipeline when it was widely seen to be environmentally unstable?
Again, the reason that we were one of the 17 or 19 banks that financed that is because our team reviewed the environmental impact, and we concluded that it was a risk that we were willing to take.